Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. I do say this thing to test whether my webcam is recording audio or not. So here I'm giving exposition on St. Luke 9, verse 22 to 25. Here Jesus foretold his future, what is going to happen. Jesus, this is a general introduction, you know, which I give to every time. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by Jesus, the First Anointed Christ of the Most High Living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, the same thing, that dwells within us, called Emmanuel. He was the First Anointed Light from our Father, and Satguru, which stands for Christ, Nanak, the Second Anointed and Greatest of all the Christs, because he had to confront the kings and emperors of darkness of Khatri tribal people against the people of Judah tribe, the princes of darkness that Jesus confronted. He came in 1469 and preached gospel to perfection through five more lives for 150 years. Still the darkness could not be comprehended. Then our Father himself came in the name of a royal king, which we call Sache Patshah in Punjabi, Gobind Ji, with his consort, we call it Shakti, Holy Spirit, in the name of Maha Devan, to sort out the stubborn sons of Satan with sword power. Sons have no authority to take the life, but our Father, who is the giver of life, and his philanthropic soldiers, which are the sons of the Most High, of Akal, Purakh, mean eternal father, Khalsas is their name. The Puritans, as in Oliver Cromwell, do have, so to sort out them, you know. So gospel according to Saint Luke 9, verse 22 to 25. Jesus said to his twice born laboring solitary brethren, and not the once born natural disciples of the rabbis, who disciplined them through the moral laws of Moses. They do what their rabbis tell them to do. Thus Saul, being the disciple of Rabbi Gamaliel, did obey him obediently. Otherwise he will be called a sinner or a bad person. As the tax collector were not attending the synagogue because they found the rabbis to be useless. And sitting in the manger of the manger won't let anybody else to eat either. So he obeyed his Gamaliel rabbi obediently as required of him, and persecuted the laborers of Jesus. But in his own heart or conscience he was not happy. So, the substitute disciple is a corruption by the Messianic Jews to set us into the same temple system. Temple system from the yoke of which Jesus set us free by giving his own life as the Lamb of God. Are they fulfilled Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. The anointed Christ of our supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., said, Jesus said, the Son of Man, Yeshua, or Yeshua, the firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother of Jesus and Joseph was foster father. Must suffer greatly and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests and the scribes, as I am rejected by these new priests with dog collar, you know, that replace rabbis, Matthew 12 verse 43 to 45, and be killed and on the third day be raised. Rabbis had Yahweh as their Lord of creation, and the one who planted Yahweh is the one who planted Abram. He's like Adam. And Sarah equal to Eve. In the Garden of Eden is the promised land. In this promised land, and fed his people lavishly when they remained faithful to Abraham and Yahweh. Jacob had 12 sons, and out of the 12, only Joseph was truthful and righteous, the salt of Abraham. And Jacob loved him the most for being the salt of Abraham. As soon as Joseph left the promised land as a slave to the Egyptians, the faithful elder son of Abraham, the land became barren, as Yahweh wasn't happy with them either, because they became unfaithful to Abraham and unfaithful to Yahweh, and Yahweh then not happy. He won't give them any rain and no food, and they had to leave. They had to leave for Egypt as a slave and suffered worse than the pigs. This is told in the parable of prodigal son. Moses brought them back faithful to Abraham, and the same land became lush green, killing the fattened calf and Mary making the parable of the prodigal son. Here, you know, the Moses himself did not accompany them, because if he had accompanied them, then they would have said, hey, this is Moses who did it. It's not the Moses, it was Yahweh who bring them the lush green, lavish field. He feeds. Yahweh create us and he feed us also if we are faithful to him. Our Father, supernatural Father, gave us the spirit, which is common sense. And if you use it, then he is inside us. If you misuse it and start robbing and cheating people, he is out and Satan is in. So it's your choice between God and Satan, or between God and Mammon. Mammon is Satan, you know. You can't love both of them. And these priests in churches, they are paid. They are hireling of Mammon. They are not working for God. So they are new rabbis. And the same became lush green, killing the fattened calf and merrymaking. The parable of the prodigal son. Here Jesus foretold them of the treatment by the temple high priest and his stooges will render him as the popes and his stooges, false fathers. You put on the robe, you know, become fathers. Give to the solitary royal priest, especially remember in Kathars, in France. They came 250 or so members of the congregation because they were not under Pope. They won't obey him. So his stooges, you know, they burnt their church and burnt them alive. He said, I think around 1400 or so, who were criticizing these hireling new rabbis in the colorful robes, did to them by throwing them before animals to be eaten alive. When the first church was, you know, taken over by the Messianic Jews, they entered the church with Jewish leaven, the Torah under their armpit. And they occupied the church and made the people drink with the old wine of the letters. The apostle used to come, and when they wanted to preach gospel, they can't receive it because they were already drunk with the old wine. So for them, you know, old wine was better than the new. So those who were sensible, they came out of such churches and they formed monasteries and other things. But they were pointing finger at those Antichrist, Pope, and so. The Pope being in collusion with the Romans, as the temple priests were at the time of Jesus, and they killed Jesus, and so the Pope and the Romans then killed apostles by throwing them before the animals to be eaten alive. Still, the spiritually blind disciple of these hireling new rabbis cannot grasp that Jesus came to set us free of the yoke of these popes by giving his own sacrifice as the Lamb of God, etc. that dominate churches that define the Church of God. You know, Jesus came to define the Church of God with one fold, one shepherd, headed by Christ Jesus, as expected of these blind neo-guides. They have different neo-blind, you know, because if you are spiritually blind, like defining an elephant, there are so many cults under Christianity. Somebody told me it's 300 and over 300 cults, you know. I went to one of their seminars in London and I told them, you know, you are blind man defining an elephant. And they said, we are happy to be blind and proud to be blind, to have so many cults. Then he said to all, if anyone wishes to come after me, that we, where Jesus is going, we need to go to have rest in the vineyard of our Father. He must deny himself or his ego. You know, some people are, you know, white. When I go to the church, you know, and tell them something, because the British had ruled over India, they still think that we have no brain, and they are the brainy one. So sometimes they listen to me, no way, because I come from outside and they ruled India. And that's why Church of England glorifies soldiers who died in World War I, World War II, whereas Salvation Army people say they died for king and country. They are nearer to God than Church of England. Deny himself or his ego. Become solitary seeker, capable of entering the narrow gate that leads to the royal vineyard of our Father, where the true vine Christ Jesus has been planted by our Father to be grafted to, and take up his own cross of rejection by these synagogues of Satan. These are churches, you know, different. The Church of England is the greatest son of Satan church. And daily, and join, not follow. We fall blind men follow others. We are not blind. We can see. And join and not follow me. Only the blind stooges follow these robed church fathers. So I go to sometimes these Orthodox church, you know, in they have John the Baptist Monastery in near London. On Sunday, you know, people go from London to that monastery in near Witham, and about 40 miles away, to attend the service. And over there, I'm a member of the Oxford Orthodox Church. You know, I go there sometime. And over there, you know, I went to with them to that monastery. First of all, I told them John the Baptist was not a saint. He was a moon. He was an angel. That's why he had the wings. And he was a witness to the light, but not the light. They don't understand. So these are the people, you know, who are carrying on these, what Pope did, you know, in the first century, these Catholic. They are the worst one, you know. Only the blind guys, stooges, follow these robed church fathers. And their church father told them not to listen to me. They used to listen to me and they stopped, you know, they turned their deaf ears. If I want to talk, they don't want to know me. So I stayed one night and came back, you know. For whoever wishes to save his life by joining the synagogues of Satan will lose it, definitely. But whoever loses his life by becoming solitary seeker for my sake or in my honor to glorify our supernatural Father will save it. We don't worship Jesus, we worship God, our supernatural Father. Jesus did not came to glorify himself, but to glorify our Father through his word, by preaching his word. We can only talk to our Father through his word, which is called logo. You must be capable of logical reasoning to have logo in your heart. Nobody can give you logo. You have to think yourself. What profit is there for one to gain the whole world as popes did, you know? The third temptation of Satan to Christ Jesus. He was taken to a high mountain, shown all this secular world, temporal authority. He said, I will give all these to you, as Pope used to be the kingmaker in Europe. As Muhammad has, Hazrat Muhammad Sahib had not put a stop to these Orthodox Church, a Catholic, you would have seen worse things. So he put the stop to them, and then these mullahs of Muhammad, Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, they created havoc in India. And then the second coming of Jesus took place in the name of Nanak. Satguru Nanak, and that I have described on top, you know, introduction. Satan to Christ Jesus, yet lose or forfeit himself the golden chance to earn rest or salvation, as demonstrated by Jesus in Lazarus, a friend of Jesus. We need to be friend of Jesus. We only can be friend when we represent Jesus. A friend represents his friend. As one in France, one friend was getting being guillotined or being beheaded. His friend, you know, went in and took his clothing, and in place of the real one getting killed, he himself got killed for the sake of his friend. This is what friends stand for. To call somebody a friend is not so simple or easy. He must represent you. So Lazarus represented Jesus, and that is why he was raised on fourth day. There are four spiritual states. ego, mind, wisdom, and his will. We call it Homme, Man, Buddhi, Chit. And so he was raised on the fourth day, and nobody could believe it. But as it was, our supernatural father wanted to demonstrate what resurrection is. So this Lazarus was shown to everyone. But when Jesus himself was resurrected, nobody could see his astral body, but only those who believed in Jesus. So our Father God blesses everyone. And I'm going to put this article, or make an article out of this, put it on my website. And if somebody can help me to improve my website, or anyway, because I'm not that technically good, it will be much appreciated. And also you can translate these articles into your own language and preach it from the rooftop in honor of our brother Christ Jesus, and to glorify our Father God. Our Father God blesses everyone.